And those guys are going to be partners tonight.
This is not good.
What an explosive situation. And it was somewhat explosive when Al Snow, who is a great friend of the fire, Mick Foley, interrupted Mr. McMahon tonight, who was in sort of a...
Wait a minute. What do you mean? It was all perfectly innocent.
Well, sure it was. So Al Snow got rewarded by getting a match here. I guess we'll find out momentarily.
Mr. McMahon was just practicing some XFL football.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Here on TNN, the debut of the XFL is this Sunday here on TNN. The Birmingham Bolts travel to the Big Apple to take on the New York Hitmen. Oh. Both teams going to be in a nasty mood.
That's right. Speaking of nasty mood, poor Al.
Thanks for the favor, Mr. McMahon. This is Al Snow's opponent.
Poor Al, he can't be happy about this. This ravenous Wolverine, he's never in a good mood. But you know what? Now that I think about it, poor Al Snow, he may not be smart enough to know what this means.
We're running out of our fans in San Diego, Bakersfield, New York City, Worcester, Mass., Cleveland, and Detroit. Tickets for upcoming WWE events go on sale this Saturday in your cities. Get them early. They won't last long. And if Al Snow doesn't tell some offense, which he is, he's not going to last long. Let's not count Al Snow short. He's one of the finest hardcore competitors we've had here in the WWF.
Yeah, but look at this. I think Mr. McMahon might have gone in and had a little personal chat with the Wolverine. He's all fired up. Oh, wait a minute.
Look at Al Snow firing back. Al Snow hammering. Benoit caught him in the temple with that shot.
Al Snow thinking of anyway, barging into Mr. McMahon's locker room. Oh! His dressing room there like that. You can't just barge in on Mr. McMahon.
Al just barged right into that steel ring post with his left shoulder. And I'll tell you what, Benoit.
Oh, God.
He's one of the most awesome competitors. Like him or not, that's your fans' prerogative. But in my view, Benoit is one of the most outstanding competitors I've ever seen anywhere.
Well, why don't you like him?
I don't dislike him. I think his personality sometimes his philosophy is a little bit questionable, but his in-ring ability is, quite frankly, scary at times.
How can you question the philosophy of a guy that'll do absolutely anything to win? That's all he thinks about. When he goes out there to that ring, all he thinks about is winning. Any cost, look at it.
Oh.
See? He's not concerned with Al Snow or his well-being.
Al Snow is getting his shoulder first in the ring post, now into the steps. This is not a no disqualification matchup, unlike our main event tonight, where Stone Cold and Triple H, who have that zero tolerance king, they can't interact physically with each other. Austin is out of the WrestleMania,
and
Triple H is suspended.
And it doesn't matter who starts it. I can't wait to see those guys tag each other tonight. How hard will those tags be? They'll be slaps.
We've already seen the camaraderie, if you will, of The Rock and Kurt Angle.
Yeah, what's up with that? Rocky must know something. What does he know, JR? You know everything.
Ooh. I don't know what you're referring to.
I don't know. All those statements The Rock was making.
As far as becoming the WWF champion?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Well, that guy Rock eats and sleeps the WWF title, as far as I know.
And man, look at.
Benoit, that shoulder.
He's going right to work on that hurt shoulder of Al Snow.
And which could be a prelude, obviously, to the Crippler Crossface, one of the most devastating submission moves in the WWF. And Al Snow, over this.
I don't think he's got the strength in that shoulder.
Yes, he does. Al Snow may have done more damage to that shoulder, but he got Benoit down on the canvas with some impact.
You know what's actually happening here? I don't think this had that much to do with Trish Stratus. Poor Al Snow's actually being punished for being Mick Foley's friend.
You're just now getting that?
Huh?
Exactly. Al Snow's been injured. He's been hurt. He's not in game shape yet. And being forced by Mr. McMahon to meet one of the most deadly and dangerous individuals in the history of the WWF. Of course Al Snow's being pinned live for being Nick Stoss.
So you're saying Mr. McMahon's not fair? We all hear all this. Look, Al Snow was thrilled to get this match. He's chomping at the bit to get back in competition.
Well, that's your story, and I'm sure you're sticking to it, King.
Well, he barged into Mr. McMahon's dressing room there, spouting off about Mick Foley.
Al Snow looking to hit one big high-risk move here.
You gotta be kidding, he got it!
That's up the moonsault. That should be it.
Oh, his arm's hurt.
The hell is he doing?
One's enough.
Al Snow, the second moonsault.
Man.
The leg's hooked. It is three. No! Can you believe, my God, that Benoit kicks out after two moonsaults.
All I can think about is I thought Benoit was beaten, and I could just imagine the look on Mr. McMahon's face. He would have flipped. Ooh.
Al Snow now trying to regroup here. I don't know what it's going to take to put Benoit down.
Uh-oh.
And there's the Benoit. The crippler crossface. The crippler crossface on Snow, who taps out. Benoit wins it, and he's ripping a good shoulder. He's ripping a Mick Foley's friend's shoulder.
Boy, it's not healthy to be friend with Mick Foley, is it?
Well, I guess not, but I certainly am one.
Oh, wait a minute.
Look at Benoit, a sadistic smile on his face.
You better not say you're Mick Foley's friend too loud. He's probably come over here. Take a look at this move. Right into that crippler crossface on that weakened shoulder. Moro Al had a tap out.